laugh. Then comes this dead grandmother lie, a move so low and so evil, it definitely guaranteed John a spot in the Survivor Villain Hall of Fame. Take a look.
Everyone to the P&B Show. My name is Preston Sibley. I'm your host, joined with my guest today, Jonny Fairplay. How are you today?
Surviving.
That is a great word to use for this episode. Jonny, you were on the TV show Survivor. And now before we get into that, I kind of want to just jump into what was life before all of that?
Let's see. I was Roddy Piper's personal assistant. I was working as a senior art consultant at Tamara Bain Gallery, representing the artwork of Olivia, and living in Los Angeles, and life was good.
That's amazing. That's and when I hear living in Los Angeles, that's my dream right there. So I want to talk about your wrestling career. So from what I know, you made your debut on January 21st in 1998. Is that correct?
So 1998, I would have been in Dimension Wrestling. So the Hardys were there, Hurricane Helms. I managed Otto Schwanz against Venom, who later became Joey Abs of the Mean Street Posse in WWE. And so, yeah, so my wrestling stuff goes back pre TNA and all that. So I'd been working independent wrestling across the country. Like I said, I started in the Carolinas, and then I ran my own wrestling promotion in Portland, Oregon after that.
That's cool. Yeah. From what I hear, it's kind of like you've been doing everything in life, really. Like
yes. There's nothing I really don't do.
No, as we were just talking before we started, that your schedule is crazy. Like, I want to give some backstory on how I got you on here. It was like a lot of maybe sometime, not right now, type like that, right? Like you're very busy, so it was very hard to get you to join me. So I appreciate that you can take the time.
I usually just say no. So I like this week, I think I'm doing 6 podcasts this week on my own network. If you want to watch, go to youtube.com/ after show. And then, for the audio, search Reality After Show with Jonny Fairplay. And then, you know, I just lined up my schedule for this year's Survivor viewing parties.
Yeah.
Next, for the premiere, I'm going to be in Cincinnati or Hamilton, Ohio, right outside Cincinnati. It's a free show. And then after that, I'm going to be in Boston. Next is Nashville, Wednesday, October 19th. And then I'm going to be in Boston, October 26th. And then I'm going to be in, what's the next one? Durham, North Carolina with the Queen, Sandra Diaz Twine on November 9th, I believe. Tickets for all those available at SurvivorTix.com. That's SurvivorTix.com. Actually, I just sold a ticket to the Durham one this very, I just got that notification. So VIP on all those are going to sell out. So, and then November 23rd, I'm going to be in New Jersey at Bolero Snort Brewery. Tickets for that available at BoleroSnort.com. But everything else, go to SurvivorTix.com and join me live. It's going to be crazy. So, yeah, my schedule is nonstop. I mean, as I was waiting for my Zoom to upgrade or whatever for this, I just locked in Victoria and War Dog. We're doing the Vessi tribe assessment tonight at 9:30 p.m. I'm working on a guest to do the Coco tribe assessment right after that at 10:30 p.m. And then I at 4:30 p.m. I'm talking the challenge finale from last night with Dan Montel and Alex Trias. It never ends. I mean, every single day of my life, it never ends.
and I thought my schedule was busy, but nowhere close to yours. Wow, that's unbelievable. How do you not get stressed out, or like?
I am stressed out. I'm always stressed. I'm always stressed out. Trust me. I'm not fun to be around at any time.
Yeah. So, as we're on the wrestling side, you attended SummerSlam this year, right?
I did. Yep. Now, my first SummerSlam. I've been to 5 WrestleManias. I'd never been to a SummerSlam.
Wow. Yeah. So I had the question of, I wanted to know what your opinion on Logan Paul being in WWE is.
He's fine. I mean, I'm not a fan of his, but I get the gimmick. I mean, I don't understand why he's not a bad guy. I mean, like, I don't think anyone there. I mean, he got some cheers just because he's going against The Miz, and The Miz is good at what he does. But I mean, the guy's a heel. So I think as soon as they figure out his role accordingly, that he's going to be good at what he does.
Yeah, I think he has something coming up again, maybe by the end of the year or something like that. But yeah, I ended up 2 weeks ago. I went to Raw in Toronto, and that was cool to see for the first time. So yeah, now I want to jump into what you are very known for is Survivor. Now, you attended the 7th season back in 2003, yes. And you are literally considered one of the biggest villains in the show's history.
I agree with that.
Now, was the audition applying stage the same back then as it is now? Like, obviously it might have improved, but was it kind of the same?
I don't know what it is now. So, okay. I mean, I would imagine it. I mean, I think now they do a lot of stuff via Zoom just because of, you know, the world that we live in and the casting for the last 4 seasons. So, but no, I mean, I think a lot of it's the same. I mean, with me, you have to consider the fact 2003, anyone that was a bad guy in reality television, they didn't feel like they were a bad guy. They're like, I got a bad edit. I wasn't a bad, you know, like that, you know, I was a good person, blah, blah, blah. And then I went there and I'm like, I want to be the biggest bad guy in the history of reality television. You know, I want to be the Joker. You know, I want to be Lex Luthor. I want to be Ric Flair. I want to be Roddy Piper. So that's what I brought to the table.
So what made you want to be on the show, and how did you prepare for it?
Well, I didn't want to be on the show. They asked me. They saw me in Los Angeles and asked me.
So, oh, really? Cool.
I said whatever. So, but as far as preparation, I'd never seen the show. So I went on eBay, ordered every episode and every early show interview in which the people explained why they felt they were voted out. I watched every season twice. I went, I was doing running Runyon Canyon twice a day. And then I went down to Catalina, became skin diver certified. And so I was, as far as preparation wise, I feel I was one of the most prepared players to ever play the game, still to this day.
So I want to talk about when someone hears your name, what your, like, basically your whole scandal that you did with your dead grandma in the show. Can you talk about what the process of that and like how that came about?
I had never seen the show. So every season when I got to the loved ones challenge, you know, I would cry watching it. I'm just like, well, there has to be some way I can use this to my advantage. And season 6 Survivor Amazon, it wasn't the loved ones challenge, but it was actually the food auction, which everyone kind of lost at the last item on purpose so that Jenna Maraska could get a letter from home because her mom was dying. And so that's when I came up with the dead grandma lie to kind of incorporate that. So, but, you know, as far as like, you know, the name Jonny Fairplay and the reactions to that name, you know, like I had done wrestling before I was Jonny Fairplay then. And so, you know, back in 2003, when I did the dead grandma lie, you know, people called me, you know, villain and liar and all those things. But, you know, I think if you look at the evolution of reality television and the evolution of strategy and just good television, I think that those names have been changed from liar and villain to legend and innovator. And any of them work, I don't care. My wallet's the same either way. It's fine. You're not gonna hurt my feelings.
So.
Oh, the dude, how's it going?
Huh?
How's it going?
She died, dude. Did you get the letter?
John, you went from really happy to really sad.
It was either going to be my buddy or my grandmother coming, and my grandmother's not here for a reason.
What happened?
She's not around. So.
Sorry for that news. I'm sure everybody here is sorry.
I don't know. I can hope to win this and get some more information.
I'll just give a little bit more information. So prior to leaving for the show, you and Dan had discussed this whole thing for when he were to come on, give you some news, stuff like that. That would hopefully give you an advantage in the game, helping him.
No. It was never for an advantage. It was for a moment. So it had nothing to do with an advantage. So no,
really.
Actually, you don't want to win that challenge. So no, it has nothing. No, the whole purpose of that was to secure my legacy as the greatest villain in the history of reality television.
Oh, really?
Had nothing to do with an advantage ever.
Oh man. That was a brilliant performance, sir.
Like that?
Yeah, thank you. Did you like mine?
I couldn't cry. I tried.
I brought on a couple tears for you.
It was sweat.
My grandmother's sitting home watching Jerry Springer right now.
John called me before he left and was like, I've got to have any sort of leverage I possibly can. He said, outsmart and outthink. He's got to outplay everybody. And he's like, if you come down here, tell me my grandma died.
Oh, I was reading when I was doing research for this episode. It said that it was so you could have an advantage in the game. Dan would dishonestly like inform you that your grandma had died, and then hopefully that the other content. That's it makes sense.
There was some sympathy to play off of, but I really didn't. I mean, like, I used it, but like that wasn't the reason for doing it. Was to make what many consider, myself included, one of the greatest moments in the history of reality television, and it still stands the test of time.
So are there still people who refuse to talk to you to this day because of that?
I mean, fan-wise, but not like player-wise.
Not player-wise? What about
What
about the relationship between like that you and Jeff had? Like, I know there was stuff there.
We're good.
Yeah?
Yeah, season 40 was supposed to be Legends. I got the first phone call.
Really?
We're fine.
Oh, that's so cool.
I mean, I'm at a much different place in my life. I was back then, I was 30 years old, and I was an a-hole. So, you know, I was a bachelor, you know, I'm 48 with two kids. So trust me, I'm at a very different place in my life.
Yeah. So what made you, I guess your viewing party that you have for each season, which is really cool. Is that just to is that for you, or is that just to get more people to watch the show, or what's that for?
I guess it's multifaceted. I enjoy my interaction with fans, and I do these minor on a much more intimate level than some of the other Survivor viewing parties out there. And I've been to the others, and I enjoy, I mean, like the others, they're a lot of fun. So, but my, like, you know, but a lot of those have, you know, 100, 200, 300 people, you know, mine have usually between 60 and 100, and, you know, throughout the commercial breaks, I'm doing trivia and I'm giving away autographed pictures of some of your favorite castaways. I do a selfie with every single person there. I try to have crazy contests and give away buffs. Thank you, Buff USA, cool, for sponsoring me each and every year. And so like Survivor's been very kind in my life. I mean, there's three three pinball tables behind me. There's a pool table and a $2,000 turntable. So, and Survivor paid for all those things. So it's just, you know, spreading the word, making new fans, and also I get to catch each city I'm in. There's typically Survivors in every city I go to. So I'm going to Boston for the first time October 26th. It's 26th or 23rd. Anyway, go to SurvivorTix.com.
Yeah, yeah.
And as of right, like I just announced it yesterday at like 3 p.m. that was going. And as of right now, I have eight survivors that are coming.
Really?
So in less
just
than,
from hearing about it and stuff.
In less than 12 hours posting it on Instagram.
That's crazy.
And then, you know, for Durham, I have the queen, you know, Sandra, my arch enemy. She's coming to my Durham show. And then, I'm lining up guests for Nashville. I have a first time guest person in Nashville that people are going to freak out about. So it's pretty nuts.
So I guess all the talk about, oh, you were the most hated person type thing, I guess over a decade, that's all changed now.
I wasn't the most hated out there when it happened. I mean, if you go back and watch Pearl Islands, the only person that told you we loved Rupert was Rupert. He sucked. The only person that told you, the viewer, that they hated me was me. No one said, go back and watch Pearl Islands. Not one person says, I'm dragging Fairplay to the end because anyone can beat him. Not one person said that, because it wasn't true. They all liked me. I'm fun. So, but I don't want to, I didn't tell you, the viewer, that, because that's not the character. My character wasn't, hey, he's the fun one.
Yeah. Now it's hard to find, like, it's available in the States to watch right back from the beginning. Now here in Canada, it's like, it's hard to find those beginning seasons. So like the only things I've ever seen from back then, before like I was even born, is like just the challenges and just the clips and stuff like that.
You guys don't have Paramount Plus?
It's not. It goes to like season 20.
Okay. Well, to get yourself a VPN, you can get anything. I'm a private internet viewer right now.
I guess, because in the States it goes Paramount Plus right back to season one, but here it's not. So yeah, I gotta check that out. But
yeah, just get a VPN. They're like go to slickdeals.com and find a special on a VPN. So I'm telling everybody, go do legal stuff. It's great. So plus, it's for your protection. People can break into your bank account. Get yourself a VPN.
Yeah. So something I didn't, so on my previous episodes, I've talked to a bunch of contestants from The Amazing Race. And now something that I noticed in Survivor, I don't know if they did the same thing there, that rehearsing the challenges, or before you guys actually do them live, right? Like, you guys rehearse them all the time.
Not necessarily rehearse them. Like, basically, Jeff says, come on in, guys, or now just come on in. And he explains the challenge that, like, you see it on television, and then they pause. And then he explains it one more time, slowly. And then we're allowed to look, but that's about it. I mean, we're doing the challenge. I mean, like, you know, we're getting mic'd up and all that. We're doing the challenge, you know, minutes later. But yeah, we're not
There's nothing beforehand. Like, I mean, they rehearse everything, but you guys aren't in there before.
No.
They say it like
you see it. He says it slower, and then you can ask a question, but and you can, you know, like, look. But yeah, there's no, I mean, it's, you're not doing the challenge before you do the challenge.
Makes sense. Makes sense. Okay. So what has it been? Obviously, we talked about you've been crazy busy every single day, but like, when you're going out in the public, getting noticed by fans, stuff like that, how's that been?
Now it's great. I mean, before, I've woken up in the emergency room, I think 3 times people would sucker punch me from behind and knock me unconscious just because, you know, so, and
just
I've gotten death threats. I had to change my phone number a few times. So no, I mean, like, there's good with the bad. So plenty of bad, but I mean, that's what I signed up for, and I'm fine with that. So, I mean, and for the record, if you sucker punch me to not, you don't need to sucker punch me. I lost a final immunity to a 70-year-old woman in a Cub Scout outfit. So like, I like your chances in one-on-one against me. So, but it is what it is. That's what I signed up for. And you know, I've no regrets. I'm happy.
Yeah. I don't really have much more to talk about. Was there anything else that you wanted to go over? Anything that we missed?
No. Just come see me live. So there we go.
Yeah.
So season 44, I'm looking at coming to Canada. Get ready.
I'll be there. Whereabouts, you know?
Roughly? I haven't decided yet. So no. maybe Toronto.
Well, if it's in Toronto, I'll be showing up. So
there you go.
That's good. Well, I think that's going to wrap it up then. I appreciate you taking the time out of your day again.
Happy to help. I admire your persistence. That's why I'm here.
Thank you. Yeah. So I'll let you go. I'll let you get on with your day. I'm sure you have a lot more planned. But
off to the gym, and then three podcasts. So
good. Well, all the things will be linked in the description for your upcoming shows and that. Yeah. All right, that's gonna wrap it up for this. Thank you all for watching. Subscribe, like, comment, everything like that. Go follow both of us on all of our social media. So it'll be in the description. And other than that, I will see you guys in the next video. Have a good day.